morning, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Mihlali. Molweni. I almost thought you were not here. I'm from the Small Enterprise Finance Agency. That's what SEFA stands for. It is an agency of government that is mandated with helping SMEs with finance. However, it's not the only agency that you will find in government that's dealing with this. I really loved the presentation and the concept that Profit Share Partners brought to us this morning. It sounds wonderful. And I don't know if anyone's still here, but I'd really like to think that it is something that is working for SMEs. And why is that? As development finance institutions, which SEFA is one of, I would say that it is quite a challenge. I know SMEs believe that they have a problem accessing finance, which could be looked at from different angles. There's a lot of money around. I think that we can agree on. If you look at the kinds of institutions that are out there, the DFI is only.
Can you give her a chance, please? If you have an urgent matter to attend to, please, you can deal with that outside and come back so that we can listen to things.
If we look at the DFIs only, we know government has got various institutions that are in place. It's not just SEFA. If you go down the road, you'll find the Eastern Cape Development Corporation, ECDC. You'll find the National Empowerment Fund, NEF. You'll go and you'll find SEDA. Although they will not give you cash, but they will still support you in terms of non-financial support as an SME. There's various institutions that you go to where you will go and find money. So we can at least agree that there is quite a bit of money around. But the issue is, how do we access it? And the access issue, if you think about it, is really about what are the requirements? What do I need to do as an SME to be able to qualify for the finance? That's something that we should rather be looking at. What is it that's not working? But I think one of the debates is, should government even be getting involved in funding, in financing whoever, not just SMEs, but whoever? And we could talk all day talking around that. I'm sure some people have got a bit of experience looking at financing with government, being financed by government. We know it takes a long time. We know that the decisions won't always be favorable to us as SMEs. But government is financing institutions. Whether they should, government should or shouldn't be, but it is happening. And one of the reasons why that is because we know traditional lending institutions, the banks, have always been there, and we have learned lessons that it's quite difficult for some SMEs to get finance from the banks. And government went into this business as well in order to provide for the people who are not able to get finance from those traditional lending institutions. And so when you're looking at institutions like SEFA, it's not necessarily to come and compete with banks. It's not to come and compete as DFIs. This is not a competition. All these institutions are there for all of us as SMEs, and it is open for any SME to approach any of the DFIs. You've gone to the bank, it's not working out, so what's next? Previously, there wasn't a next, but now there's government that is able to assist you. And so this is not to say that there's a SEFA in place so that you can't go to the bank. We actually prefer that you go and find finance at the bank. And if you can't, for whatever reason, as we know, then there's a CIFA for you. And therefore, as I go through the presentation, please give the background. CIFA is not a lender of first choice. People who are able to get finance from the bank, that's fine, that's where you should be going. Or if you are able to get finance with profit share, that's also fine. And if you are able to get finance with NEF, that's also fine. And at one of your options is a CIFA. As I've said, CIFA is an agency of government. We are reporting to the Department of Small Business Development. Previously, there was an institution that was called CULA and an institution named SAMA. Those two institutions were merged in order to form CIFA in 2012. And since CIFA has started work, there are a number of SMEs that have been assisted. It hasn't been easy. If some of them were here, they will tell you that it is a journey that you have to embark on. And CIFA is also reporting to the IDC. So the finance that you will access through CIFA comes from the Industrial Development Corporation. And what is our lending model at CIFA? If you look at, it is an institution that you find across the country. It's national. Every province has got one CIFA office. In the Eastern Cape, we are based in East London. There is a branch that is in Port Elizabeth and one that is in Mthatha. And if you come to a CIFA institution, there's three different things that you are able to access. Some people are involved in companies that are lending finance to small businesses. There is a unit within CIFA that's known as the wholesale lending unit, where you are able as a company to come and get a lump sum or bulk finance, which you will then take and on-lend to other SMEs. Of course, I think part of my background should be to say that as different DFIs that are mandated to work with SMEs, CIFA's mandate only covers business loans. People who are interested in grants, we are able to access through the Department of Trade and Industry, DTI. And so within CIFA, it is a business loan. If you're not able to finance anything else, it's not personal loans, it's not building loans, it is just for business purposes. So whatever we talk about only relates to your business. And therefore, for those who have companies that are lending to SMEs, then CIFA is an opportunity for you where you can take money and go and on-lend it to other SMEs. Then also, what you can also get through CIFA is if you are borrowing money from the bank and the bank needs collateral which you do not have or you do not have enough, then you are able to the bank will approach CIFA on your behalf and say, we would like to lend money to this SME. However, they need assistance with collateral. And what you are also able to get at CIFA is a direct business loan, which is amounts of anything from 50,000 rands, which is our minimum, up to 5 million. And that you can apply directly at any CIFA office in the country. And what you can do then with that direct loan, what are the things that we're looking at? We're looking at asset finance. We're looking at term loans for people who are already in business and people who would like to start a business. And we're also looking at revolving loans for our repeat clients. If you've been at CIFA, you were financed, and now you are looking at additional finance, then there's a revolving business loan for you. Bridging loans for people who would like short-term finance where you've won a tender, you've got an order from somewhere that you would like to service. And we have a specific fund that is called Amavulandlela Fund, which is looking specifically for people who are physically challenged, that we know as disabled. And this is a special fund for the disabled, which gives finance to them at a discount. Now, at a discount, I know the question that we'll ask ourselves is, if you're taking this money from SIFA, at what cost does it come to you? And we're looking at interest rates of plus minus 15%, and therefore it is not cheap money. We would like that it would even be cheaper. However, as an institution that is running at cost, we've got sustainability issues as well, and this is why there is interest that is charged to it. I've spoken about the wholesale loans. Anyone who's interested in the wholesale loan where you're taking finance from SIFA to go and on-lend to ask the other SMEs, we can perhaps have a discussion, and I would refer you to people that are more relevant. Business support at SIFA, as I've said, I mentioned SIDA to you, where I said that they are able to assist you with non-financial business support. These are sister institutions that are both reporting to the same department. So when SIFA offers business support, it is not to redo what SIDA does. SIDA does what they do, and what SIFA will then help you with is, if you are an institution that has taken money from SIFA in order to go and lend to other institutions, then SIFA will be able to support you in terms of how capacity building within your company as an SME. But what we also offer is for SMEs that have been able to get finance from SIFA, we then also offer mentorship. And therefore, mentorship is not a standalone benefit that you can get from SIFA. It's only if you've been financed. And so if you've received finance from the Department of Social Development, for example, you aren't able to come to SIFA just to come and ask for mentorship. It only covers those that were financed by SIFA. Credit guarantees is the collateral that we're able to assist with when you go to get funding for finance from the bank. Then rental property, we don't have any of that in the Eastern, in the East London area, but in the PE area, we've got a few properties that are being utilized by SMEs at a rental fee, of course. In terms of why SIFA, I have indicated that it is expensive money in the sense that you will pay interest of about 15% or so. And I'd also like to mention that there is an initiation fee that is charged when you start with the loan. That can also be capitalized or added onto the loan that you are looking at. And that initiation fee is up to 5% of the amount that you're applying for. And so the longer the term that you apply for, then the less the amount. If you're taking a five-year loan, because that's the maximum you can get at SIFA. If you're taking a five-year loan, then your initiation fee is likely to be 1%, 2% at most. But if you're taking a short-term loan, short period, then it's likely to be 5% once off at the point that the loan facility is commencing. In terms of risk, as I've said, you've gone to the bank, they have not funded you for whatever reason, and therefore we believe that at SIFA we're able to overlook some of the things that the bank has declined you for. One of the questions that I know is likely to come out up is, I am listed by one of the credit bureaus, and so will SIFA assist me? Yes, SIFA can assist you, provided you are able to talk to the issue that has resulted or the circumstance that has resulted in you being listed on a credit bureau. Now, how you talk to it is in being able to provide information. What have you done about it? You were a student and didn't pay an account, and now and it was a small amount and now I was listed, or there was a dispute and I've taken up that dispute through my lawyers and so I've been listed, and so we would like to know what happened and what have you done about it. And you would understand that part of the problem is that we're giving you money and therefore we are going to look at your character. And so we cannot work with situations where you've had loans or unpaid debt and you haven't done anything about it. All that we're looking at is that you have not run away from your responsibilities. If it's an issue, you fight it and there is correspondence to that effect. It could be that you had already paid and you've got proof that you paid and that covers it. We just wanna know, what did you do about it? And one of the questions that people tend to ask us is the question of contribution. I think back in the day when we were talking about cooler days, in those days, there used to be a need for an SME to provide a contribution of some sort towards the business. It's not necessary. You don't need to have a contribution. You come, you're looking for finance, and what we are going to look at is this business viable? Is it profitable? Is it going to be able to pay back this loan? And some people are of the viewpoint, it's government money, why must I pay it back? And there's others that are coming behind you. You get given this money, you pay it back so that we can assist SMEs that will come and knock here tomorrow looking for the same kind of assistance. It's unfortunate, program director. I would like to mention that perhaps there are business associations that are here, and this is where they come in. Because we have found that since 2012, when SIFA began, money's been given to SMEs who have decided that they would just run away with the money and not come and pay it back. And guess what? In 2018, when somebody comes knocking at our doors, the criteria has now become even tougher than it was before, because lots of people took the money and they ran because they helped themselves. They didn't think about us who are here today, who would like to be assisted tomorrow. And so I think our business associations, we need to work together in terms of the education and awareness that it may be government money, but it's for all of us. And if you run away with the money, you run away with taxpayers' money. And so you run away with our money, not SIFA's money. In terms of security, this is one of the questions that we normally get as well. Do I need to have collateral? You don't need to have security. If your business plan shows that the business is profitable, it's going to be able to pay back the loan, then that's good enough for us. We don't need to have we don't need you to have security. But one of the interesting things is that you will find applicants who come to for assistance. They've got collateral, and guess what? You ask them, are you willing to put your let's say you have a house, and are you willing to put it down as security? And that answer tells us a lot. Whether you say yes or you say no, it tells us a lot in terms of what you believe regarding this venture that you want to go into. I'm not going to say what it tells us, but it does tell us something. One of the other things, a program director, that I'd also like to put out here as well, is that SIFA is looking at loans of 50,000 minimum, going up to 5 million. And what we have learned is that there seems to be no interest, or there seems to be a gap in the market in terms of people or companies that are providing for microfinance. That in our area, it doesn't seem to be happening. You come to CIFA, CIFA says we start at 50,000. You go to ECDC and maybe ECDC will say we start at 10,000. But for people who are looking for small loans, there is a problem in our area. And I believe this is an opportunity for somebody to take up and run with it. You find institutions like CIFA who will say, come and get finance and we'll finance you, and you go and online. People who want 500 rands, people for business, and somebody will walk in and say, I have a tender from the Department of Health, I need to provide towels for the hospital, I need 9,000 rands. There's nowhere for people to go looking for that kind of money. And so in our area, we are challenged. We've spoken about it previously. I don't know, it was 2 or 3 years ago, but it is still an issue. Microfinance in our area is not happening. And why is it not happening? That's a question that we need to be looking, and maybe not just looking at a question, but making a provision for it. It's a business opportunity for somebody. And in terms of our criteria, these are the basic things that you will tend to find in wherever you go and apply. We don't want the money to go out of the country. It's taxpayers' money. It's got to stay within the country. And for people who are non-South African, they at least need to be permanent residents. But over and above that, we also look at the profit share in whatever business that they are running. Business got to be registered, you got to have a tax clearance certificate, and you need to be able to. If you don't have a business loan, then you must have an order or contract that you want to service. And you don't need both. You just need one of those two. If you have an order, you don't need a business plan, and vice versa. And one of the critical things is you will find a Mihlali who's working for CIFA who decides, you know what, I'd like to run a business also. And you can't, Mihlali can't apply at CIFA. For as long as you are in employment, for as long as you are running many other businesses, you can't apply at CIFA. You need to be where the money is going. And so if you want to be funded by CIFA, we must know the business is going to be managed by the owner. We've learned the hard way, and as SMEs, I believe this is something that you'd understand. If the owner of the business is not in the business, then we have a problem. And these are businesses that we do not fund. Basically, it's got to be legal. It's got to meet the legislative issue requirements of in the country, and that should be good to go. And anything that's got to do with ammunition, this what is known as the sin industry, alcohol, tobacco, that sort of thing, we won't do. But here's the question. I'm running a restaurant, and my clients would like to have something to drink, and it will not always be soft. In that case, we can then look at your application. However, if you're going to be selling drinks that are not soft drinks, then you need to be licensed. Hence, I mentioned the issues of legislation. And in terms of legislation, you will also find instance, whatever industry that you are in, you need to meet the legal requirements. If, for example, you say, I would like to start a business and I want to make blocks, building blocks or bricks or paving, whatever, and you find them, as you drive towards this side of towards the Kai and beyond, you will find people who have started businesses, they're making bricks and they are along a river somewhere because there's water. And the question that we would like to know is whether what you are doing is legal. The water that you are getting from there, do you have a permit? The sand, if you are mining sand and you're using it, do you have a permit? We look at those kinds of things. If you are mining, there's legal requirements around that. What I would like to mention is primary agriculture as SIFA, we do not fund. However, we will fund it if you have an off-take agreement where somebody has given you an order for cabbages and you'd like to get started with that. In that case, we will help. An interesting need in the Eastern Cape is around property development. I've got a plot. I'd like to develop it and rent it out. We say it's speculation. Nothing says that you are going to get tenants whenever you do build your flats. And so that we will not work with. In terms of turnaround times, 6 to 8 weeks, and I know that's something that is we're likely to ask. The pricing formula I've mentioned, initiation fee, maximum 5%, and also interest, we're looking in the region of 15%. And thank you, Program Director. My 2 minutes is up.
Good day. My status quo is still not finished. But I'm finished about right. First of all, Tim Patrick, ne, soon is from Days Products. Yeah, in Islanda. The financial supporter that does in Mutushane. My company is one of the companies that will be on that project. We intend to pilot a project, a rural one. Say, Atlas is Utiban and that was a Puma. So that's bonus Nelson and Dona Elani. Right, the boy and the boys again will go up a voice. Mihlali, no, was our Kumbula last presentation. I think it was in Duncan Village. The following day, we went to your office. Sorry, at the phone, I tell you, Mihlali, the phone aspect clear. Then we went to your office. The first thing when we arrived at your office,
Protection,
you don't have to point at my speakers, please. Okay.
Just raise the point. If there's a question, you raise the question. If there's a recommendation, you deal with the recommendation.
The question is startup businesses. How is SIFA helping startup businesses? Let me just.
Can I answer these three so long, Chair?
Yes. That's allowed.
Okay. Thank you for the questions. The comment about what's happening at me, Dushan, we would love to come. And in fact, because SIFA is only in the three areas that I mentioned, Eastland and BE and Tata, we also co-locate at SIDA offices, and we would not like to see any person traveling long distances just to go and get information. So if you are able to phone us and we call you back, if you are able to request us to come and see a group of people, that we do with pleasure. So we'd love to come, Dr. Engos. And we would also like to say the question about whether we help startups at all, yes, we're helping startups and existing business. And I think I'd just like to qualify it with regards to the last question. It may seem that SIFA is not helping startups, and it goes back to what I said regarding companies being able to show viability, being able to show profitability. We need to see that this business can afford the loan and can be able to pay it back. And so your business plan needs to show that. And that's the reason why there may be a question mark as to whether startups can be assisted or not.
Thank you.
Thanks. Let's continue.
Thank you very much. My name is Uluvo Gray. My question, I would like to start with the statement. The government talks in the National Development Plan says that by 2030 they would want to have most 90% of jobs to come from the SME sector. I don't know how they're going to do that, because when you look at the government finance institutions and the development institutions, they have perpetuated the apartheid's partial planning system when it comes to developing entrepreneurs. Instead of going to where the entrepreneurs are, you expect the entrepreneurs to go to where you are. So my question is, what are your pipeline plans in terms of having satellite offices in Tanzania, Esnad Park, and all the rural areas? Because when you look at your targeted groups, it speaks to black people, it speaks to youth, it speaks to disabled people, but more than women, thank you very much. But when you look at where these people are, there are no SIFA offices, because I'm thinking of it in a business perspective. When ShopRite wants to open, sees that the customers are in Mtanzania, they go to Mtanzania. As SIFA, your customers are in the townships. So it would make sense for you to be in the townships. That is my first point. And then my second point, when you go to finance institutions, right, particularly venture capital, they always ask you about debt or equity. Do you only offer debt, or do you also offer equity? Thank you very much.
Hello, my name is Nisa Mfata. I just have one question. You mentioned something about people that lend money from your institution and then they run away with the money. Now that leads you to tighten the criteria for the next year. Now, wouldn't it be better for you to chase your money and not tighten
Okay, mine is also to Lucy's, because the UCC preservation that was focusing on more on women. No, I'm still. Mihlali. It's around your office in the area. It's so painful when sometimes we'll be in the office, we do not have information, and we'll have a reception, we'll pay the labor. Sometimes the documentation that we get there is difficult for Omnium to go through all those things that are needed. Your audited financial statement, I didn't see them there. Only one of your requirements, because on the forms they are there. We don't have these things. So, but if we speak one on one with you, explain to me and assist me in terms of where can you get this thing, where can you get this one, so that make it easier for us to see access is loads. I went there with the appointments. I'm SE3 from DBSA. I went with DBSA. For 3 years, I've got a 3-year contract with DBSA as a surety. He said, here are my contracts with DBSA. I want this amount for this business. This one will fund this one. So this is the amount that I need. So it was difficult for me. And then I ended up saying, okay, let me fund it from my own pocket. You know? That's what we are doing now with other agencies. We are really tired. But again, today was our fairness on us that safe. Thank you, sir.
We had one hand this side.
Thank you so much for the comments. I'll start with the last comment. I really appreciate the feedback. Because when we sit in those offices, there is a set way of doing things. There's a procedure that's on paper that says this is how it must be done. And we've got our own experience in terms of what happens. And it's really good when we are also able to get feedback from you. Because now when you're explaining to me what happened in your situation, I really can't figure out why you had to go away and find your own means. Although I'm sure for you it was a blessing in disguise that in the end you didn't enter into debt. You were able to find a way to do it yourself. However, I really don't understand why we were not able to assist you. So thank you very much for mentioning it. And also, I think, Puti, I take it that you were also commenting when you say, why are we tightening and not chasing? The chasing is happening. However, it's not our strong point. And I think that's why many people then decided to run for it, because they know it's a government institution, there's a process in place, and how the legislation is, and trying to chase money that's gone is really sometimes a waste. But now it says we are aware, we know what we're likely to get. And so when you come today, it's really not that easy, but we are chasing the money at the same time. And in terms of debt and equity finance, yes, we do, but debt we do not do. So if you've already spent the money and you'd like to get money from SIFA to come and pay for money that you have spent already, we don't get involved in that. We won't be able to assist. But in terms of your comment around us going into townships and different areas, I think you will appreciate the fact that as we are saying, there's a limited amount of money. And as Usbusiso was presenting here earlier, Mr. Mbobe? Yes. You have to make a decision. Do you spend your money opening offices everywhere and employing people, and then you don't have enough money to actually assist SMEs because all the money is going, or most of the money is going to salaries? But what we are doing is that we co-locate at SIDA offices, as I mentioned. We go to Mdanzane every week on Thursdays. There's someone who goes and to work a highway where the Buffalo City Metro office is for LED at the library. There's someone from SIDA there every Thursday. And so that's what we're trying to do. That's how we started in Mthatha. We go to Queenstown every second Tuesday. And so it's our way of trying to reach out. But as I said, a phone call, an email, a request to say, come through, we are a number of SMEs, we'd like to get information, we're happy to do that.
Thank you. Just checking, thank you to Anthea for the presentation. I think we need more initiatives like that, in especially around this land. This is one. Ndikumamela ngokuthetha uyithethe ngathi le nto yolahleka kwale mali yinto efana nje noNSFAS nabantu abangambhataliyo, and it scared me. Ndiyayika ohlobo uyithetha ngalo, uthethe ngathi i-encouragement luba nathi masiye soyithatha sibaleke. Apho ndibhalele khona wena siswami into yoba if kule presentation yakho andiyibonanga le nto iliphupha lam, do I still come to you, siyithethe, sibonisane, nam zokwazi uba imali, sibeza njani? Enkosi.
Thank you. A quick question, Suswamo. These criteria that you put in place to vet, to get money, because I'm looking at a situation whereby currently, how many startups that you guys have assisted?
From Amulet Developers, umbuzo wam kancinci okanye ikhomenti yam iyafuna ukuthi ncapha kubhuti ne. Kule nto yodivelopha ndithi nantsi ifama ne okanye nomhlaba. ndiza kokha so and so. Ndiza appointa aba bantu ba that qualify ukwenza I feasibility studies, yeah? Ndize nayo la report that yes you will make money lo BNB yakho if yiyo okanye kwezo flat or whatever. Ndi accompanyishe with my business plan. The application if I get pakubo. Even low point layo, abazoi accept and abazab speculation.
There's the last hand there.
Afternoon everyone. My name is Sandiswam Golozeli. I run a PR and marketing agency and an interior design company. Mine is rather a solution than a question and is directed to Anthea. Availing my services to assist the clothing bank going forward with marketing and PR.
Okay. The issue of let me just first clarify the speculation around property development. If the property is meant for business, that's fine. If you are going to buy a farm and run activities on it and there is a bankable or profitable business plan in place, that's fine. You are renting a space somewhere and you are running a travel agency and you'd now like to buy the building to continue the travel agency, that's all right, because it's for business purposes. However, if you are saying, I'm gonna get this piece of land, I'm gonna build flats and I'm gonna rent them out, that is speculation. You see the difference? So there must be a business that you are going to run. If you have a BNB and you'd like to, maybe you're renting it now, but you want to buy it, or you're gonna buy it and start a BNB, that's fine, that's a business. Where the issue of the startup comes from, and again, I think maybe I should say, I acknowledge that startups do have a problem, and this is why this question keeps coming up around startups. It's got a, there's a problem there, as I said, our issue is with startups, even existing business, you need to be able to show that this business is going to make profit, is going to afford, and this is a legal requirement. We can't lend to businesses that cannot afford a business loan. That is a legal requirement. And so, as an entrepreneur, you need to be able to talk to your business. Many times, this business plan comes through, they were developed somewhere by somebody, and when we have a conversation, you are not able to show that you understand what's happening in this business plan. In some case, because somebody somewhere drafted this business plan. They did not even consult you. And so this is where the problem begins. We need to get an understanding. You need to show us that this business is going to make a profit, and that is the hard part, because there's many things that come into it. And so you can't just say to me, I want to open this business and it's going to make money. We need to be able to go through how it's going to make money. What is it going to do? How are you going to make money? You buy this garage, there's 20 other garages out there. Why are people going to come to yours and pass all those other ones? And that's a conversation and a point that you need to be able to bring across for this to become successful. And that's where the problem is with startups, that they aren't able to show and that this is really going to work.
I think that was a comment. Let's take our speakers, but I just want to flag three opportunities that in their presentation are picked up. One is the issue of micro-franchising. We've got brilliant ideas and we do them in our own corners. You know, how can I find chicken started from at the whole world, I don't know. But we've got certain things that are really exclusive to our own environment. I think this is what Lydia is talking about. And I don't think, I haven't had anybody ask me anything about that. What exactly, I think that's one of the things that we need to engage for. The second one is around the mentorship of your small enterprises so that they don't run with your money. We provide the service to provide anybody who's business development.
Should have commented.
Provide the support. Yeah, I'm just raising those. The last one is the issue I heard you talking about working in offices in Tanzania before in other areas. I think in our culture, visibility, as one of the speakers spoke about the branding, you know, and all that. There's an opportunity, I think, with SASA Bay in various villages all the time, throughout, you know, every week they're in one village, you know. And I think that's also an opportunity for SIFA, either through an agency services or directly, that they provide the service to that church. It's something for thought. I think I it's important.
Yes, I wanted to just comment on the issue of my mentioning to you that people are running away with the money. It's got to be mentioned so that when you are not able to get a business loan from a DFI, we need to hold one another accountable, because currently an individual SME comes across and gets the money and does not bring it back. And tomorrow, another SME is suffering because of it. And we need to all not take responsibility, but we need to watch out for one another. And this is why I specifically said business associations that are here, we need to create awareness and educate one another on how our conduct in the business space is affecting one another. We do need to be each other's keepers in a way. Currently, people are going into cahoots to try and rob, but it's taxpayers' money, it's your money. And when you know that this is what has happened to it, then you shouldn't feel that it's SIFA's money. It's your money as a taxpayer. It's my money as a taxpayer. And so we need to take responsibility for it. It is not meant to encourage you to get it and run away. And if you did not see your dream in what I mentioned here, I mentioned specifically the things that we do not fund, and everything else we then should be able to fund. Thank you.